I want to have a conversation with you today that's very important. I want to ask you a question. Tell me, who are you? Someone asked you that question, who are you? Is your answer going to be, I am, and you'll say your name. So I'll say my name, I'm Michelle. If someone says to you, who are you? I'm a pastor. Someone says to you, who are you? Well, I'm so-so-so's daughter, or I'm Christopher's wife. I want you to know something. That's not who you are. See, if I answered that question in that way, I would want you to say to me, but that's not really who you are. Do you understand that when someone asks you, who are you? Who are you? Can you really understand what that answer ought to be? Because I'm going to tell you right now, I'm a spirit being in a human body. What do I mean by that? I'm body, I'm soul. My soul is my mind, my will, my emotions. And there's my spirit man. And the truth of who I am is who the one who made me says I am. And who made me is God, the true and living God of the universe. And he's a spirit. So as his child, I want you to know that if you asked me who I am, who are you? I'll say to you, I am a child of God. And I want us to have a conversation about it, because I'll tell you something. Many of us have grown up believing we are what people have said about us. Maybe you've not been told that you're pretty. Maybe you've been told you're ugly. Maybe you've been told that you're dancy. Maybe you've been told you're just not good enough. And so you've grown up believing that who you are is someone who, you have a name, but the names that really have defined you have been, you're not good enough, you're not pretty, you're rejected, and all kinds of wrong beliefs. I want to say to you today, it's time to know who you are. And a lot of times, I mean, we're having a conversation, right? So you are entitled to answer back. I'm on social media, so it's going to be a little difficult. But maybe you need to note what I'm saying, and maybe you need to start to write down the thoughts that come to you. Because I think that many of us define ourselves as well through our jobs, our financial status. I mean, if you have a job that you've always wanted, it could become your identity. Your successes could become your identity. The way you look. I mean, what about if you went out and you didn't have on any of the makeup? I'm not saying makeup, anything is wrong with makeup. But I've heard people say, if I go out without makeup, like, I don't want nobody to see me, like I would never allow someone to see me. Maybe we're defined by our parents. Lots of other things, what people say about us. And so my question to you is, if you are defined by your job, your parents, what people say about you, what happens when you experience failure? What happens when they don't say something nice about you? What happens when they catch you in the drugstore without any makeup? Or, and I'm not talking to only females, I'm talking to males as well. Yeah, there are a lot of males that if they're not dressed a certain way, they're not going to be seen anywhere else. And what happens when you become burnt out in your job and you can't do what you used to do? Are you still full of purpose? Do you still have an identity? You see, I'll tell you something. It's important for us to know who we are truly, because that identity of who we are will never change if it's through Christ. All other identities will be shaken. Those are the false identities that we assume because we don't know better. And so what happens is, anytime a particular identity that we have presented to the world gets shaken or changed, we hustle to form another identity. But when you know your identity in Christ, you will operate out of that. Out of that, you do your job. Out of your identity in Christ, you will have an appearance. You will dress according to your identity in Christ. You will speak according to your identity in Christ. You will relate to people out of your identity in Christ. I want you to know that any other identity that you trust in, and I'm talking about here what we are identifying as false identities and external things, will be shaken, because when circumstances change, that identity is going to change. So let's say you're on social media and someone doesn't like your picture. It's going to bother you. You know why? Because your identity is in what you present to the world. And I'm here to say to you today, let's have a conversation about your identity in Christ, so that whatever you say, whatever you do, whatever you show to the world will not be shaken, because you will show them and you will respond to them through your identity in Christ.